are here to be able to talk about the plight of the elderly in the country Uganda. And today I'm joined by Dr. Betty Wako to be able to discuss the efforts that are being taken by their organization to be able to reach out and improve the livelihoods of the elderly in the country. Doctor, you're most welcome.
198 of the seniors did not even know they were hypertensive.
Wow.
And that's a big, big red flag. Many had bone issues. Many had diabetes, which was not diagnosed, and some had very severe diabetes.
11%, this is a big number, and most of them live singularly, and probably they have divorced. Some of them have your kids who have migrated to urban areas and they live alone. So how much of a problem is this, especially with what you came to find out when you went to visit these people in the villages?
Many of them were widows and widowers who were directly referred to our program for enrollment. And so I do think that the being alone is a big problem for our seniors. And some of them, you know, looked, you could see that they were kind of destitute. But I also think that being alone is not only the problem, but being alone with medical conditions and hungry is even a bigger problem. Yes.
And you came up with this organization. What really drove you and gave you that sticking point and say, let's get started to be able to reach out to these senior citizens in the country, Uganda?
How seniors in the U.S. died.
Yes.
We understand because they were probably in a nursing home and the disease spread faster, but we did not know to what extent our seniors were impacted, because for a very long time after the second wave, the country was locked down. Sure. And there was supposed to be a food distribution, but we know not everybody got that food. So in that plight, if you are alone, your children can't even drive to you, or you can't even have energy to go to the garden, we thought this was a very critical problem that we needed to reach out to our seniors. Yeah. And engage them and see what was lacking so that we could come in. And in that case, we conducted an assessment and we found that it was a severe problem for some of our seniors who were not having any assistance from their children, or because they were widowed or some other reason, debilitated with disease.
You say people actually received very professional services.
Yes.
that in fact you received in a while.
Yes.
How did it feel like for these elderly people?
The appointment was 9 a.m., but the seniors had already sat and waited.
I saw the numbers.
Yes.
Very, very vast numbers.
And so we conducted weight measures.
Sure.
We conducted MUAC measures for the arm. We conducted blood sugar and blood pressure. After that, they would be moved to see the doctor.
Now that you have offered the services, how do we see this sustained? Because now when you're going back to the States, what have you left on the ground to ensure that these elderly people can actually have a continued support?
So they will be assessed and reviewed by a medical doctor.
Okay.
At the same facility every month.
Okay.
And the feeding program or the congregate meal program is going to start this year. We are still putting it together. And we'll ensure that when it's a meal program, we have the meals, and ensure that, you know, that it doesn't go to feed other people who do not qualify.
Definitely.
And that's all that you also understand could be affecting the sustainability of the meal program.
Okay. The nutrition right now and the immediate intervention that you're going to put in place to ensure there's continued improved nutrition, because that's the first medication I think the elderly people need.
Many of the seniors said, meaning we are hungry.
Yeah, sure.
And so we told them we'll be bringing a meal program to at least fill in certain gaps. It won't be 7 days a week.
The elderly account for over 11% of our population, and most of them are most vulnerable and they need a lot of services to be able to cope and live healthy and be able to live an amazing life in our society. I am Paul Onyala, Urban TV News continues.